Hi, I'm Amy Ford, and I'm going to teach you all the basics for accounting for investments. Now, this is a topic that can get really confusing with all the different methods. So we'll walk through all the basics together, step by step, in this video. Let's start by discussing the two basic forms of investments, equity and debt. Equity investments, or equity securities, are investments where our company is investing in the equity of another company. In other words, our company purchases stock of another company. So for example, our company, we're company A, purchases stock of company B. Debt investments, or debt securities, are when our company invests in the debt issued by another party. So for example, company C has borrowed money using bonds. If we, company A, purchase the bonds being issued by company C, we have a debt investment. We're going to start by covering all the basics for equity securities. Now, the first thing you want to know are the accounting rules for how to record the equity securities. That's one of the really tricky parts. How you account for the investment in equity securities varies on the equity investment. The accounting rule used is based on the degree of influence that you have over the company in which you invest. So if our company, company A, purchases stock of company B, the accounting rule we use to account for this investment depends on the percentage of the stock we hold of company B. If you own 0 to 20% of the stock of the other company, you really don't have much influence or control over the other company. In this case, you will use the fair value method. If you own 20 to 50% of the stock of the other company, you begin to have more influence or more control over the decisions and direction of the company you have invested in. In this case, you will use the equity method to account for your investment. In the final category, if you own 50% or more of the company, you have major influence and control over the company that you've invested in. When you own more than 50% of the company, the consolidation method is required to account for your investment. Now, don't worry, we'll go through each of those step by step. Is what we've covered so far giving you a better understanding of investments? I hope that you've learned something. If you want to learn more about equity securities and debt securities, including all the details, then click the link below or go to glime.com and look for our free basic accounting course in the CPA free resources section. In the course, you will find great information on other topics, such as all the details on how to prepare financial statements and perform financial statement analysis, which can really help you in your financial accounting classes. So click below or go to glime.com to learn more.